It's not just an ordinary Tuesday. Welcome to Terrier Tuesdays, the show where you can get to know some of Boston University's best and brightest student athletes.
Welcome to another episode of Terrier Tuesdays. My name is Scott Ellis, and I'm joined by Boston University softball senior Jen Horita. And Jen, the Patriot League tournament starts Thursday. You're coming off your third straight conference regular season title. How are things going on your end?
They've been great. Honestly, this year has been so fun. Just the group of girls has been great. We are in unprecedented times with COVID, obviously, but we are making the most out of it, and I'm really excited for the tournament this year.
Well, and speaking of making the most out of it, to be 33-2, I mean, when you hear that, how did that happen this year with everything else going on to almost have a perfect regular season record?
Yeah, I mean, after coming off of last year not being able to play, I think a lot of the girls on the team were really hungry to get back on the field. And given that we were given the opportunity to be able to play this year, I think all of us are really making the most of that and putting our all into making this year the best that it can possibly be.
Right. But obviously, as you know, a lot of those games came down to the wire, and you obviously have two losses. And the reason I bring that up is it's going to be tough in the Patriot League tournament, but you've had the experience, you've won two titles. But the other thing too is half the team has never competed in postseason action. So what have you and the other upperclassmen been telling the freshmen and sophomores going into the tournament?
Yeah, I mean, the freshmen and sophomores are great. They work so hard at practice, but I think having the upperclassmen who have the experience, it's been really awesome to be able to set an example for them and really set the tone at practice on the field, and just give them a little bit of a calming feeling that it's like they can relax and just play the game and have fun, and everything will work itself out.
Right. And speaking of having fun, I mean, right now you're like 20th in the country in batting average, batting around 440. I mean, what's been the secret to your success this year?
I think it all goes back to really taking advantage of the opportunity and, you know, practice this year, working together as a team. I think just being within myself and really focusing on things that I need to do as a teammate, as a player, to help our team succeed and whatever that takes has really been what I've been focusing on this year.
Right. And obviously talking about the bats, but one thing I really enjoy watching you and the other outfielders do is make those diving catches. And I mean, right now the team has the lowest ERA in the country. Can you just talk about the defense and how much pride you and AJ and Lauren, and then obviously your predecessors how much pride you have in your defense in the outfield?
Yeah, I mean, it's just such a fun feeling to make diving catches, make big plays. And I think Coach always talks about it, like our defense, that one diving play, that one diving catch is what sets us apart from other teams. And that's something that we really focus on at practice. And obviously we're fine tuning things going into the tournament, but you know, we are just really working hard at practice to get ourselves prepared to be able to make those plays in the tournament come up big.
Right. And just wanted to ask you about the beginning. I mean, you're in your fourth year here at the program. I mean, how did you end up at BU?
You know, BU is a great school, and obviously there's so much to do in Boston. It's such a great city. And I think having talked to Coach and met some of the players when I initially visited, but it's such a great environment, and the girls and the team all together is such a great place to be. And it's honestly been such an amazing decision that I will not replace for the world.
Right. And asking you about academics, I mean, how has that transition been this year? I know you've been able to probably go to some classes, but how has that worked out the past year for yourself?
I mean, I think it's something that everybody kind of has to adapt to as they go, but obviously everybody is kind of in the same situation right now with online classes and whatnot. But I think the staff and coach as well has been really, really accommodating in terms of people figuring out what they need to do in the classroom and also what they need to do on the field to perform.
Right. And speaking of being able to perform on the field, is now you're done with finals. So how much of a relief is that to just be able to focus on the tournament?
I mean, it is a huge weight off our shoulders not to have classes anymore and to really let that stress like be released. But yeah, it's really fun to only think about softball and really just have our complete focus on that.
Right. And then a couple more questions. I mean, what does it mean to be able to host the tournament a third straight year?
Playing on our field for us is such a comforting and awesome feeling. I think we as a team, because we are able to practice here all the time, it's a very relaxing feeling to be able to play on our home turf. And it's always awesome. Most of the time having fans, but even just the environment itself and being able to play at home is really awesome. And it gives us a little bit more confidence on the field.
Right. And finally, I know we've kind of talked about, but I'll ask you one more time. What is it going to take to keep that trophy at BU?
I mean, Coach always says it, teams show up to the tournament and we need to bring our best. So coming into the tournament, we really need to focus out, fine tune things. But I think our group is such a great group of girls and everybody works so hard that as long as we just focus on ourselves and really what we need to do, we can get the job done.
Right. Well, thanks for joining me, Jen, and good luck this weekend.
Of course.
Thanks for tuning in to Terrier Tuesdays. Give us a follow on our social media accounts at BU Athletics on Twitter and Instagram for more content.